looking into the future of how we can be as a team in 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 4 weeks. No, we're there. You know, as when we come together, when we pay attention to details, we're as good as any team in the league. So we're where we need to be. We just need to make sure that we're tightening things up and just paying attention to details and playing together.
So it sounds like the confidence is still really high in that locker room, despite what you guys are at.
Oh yeah, we got ball players, man. We got ball players. We got confident shot makers. We got facilitators. We got all types of players that just love the game and have passion for the game. And when you bring that together, and the level of focus, you know, we can beat anybody. I just started getting to the cup. You know, I felt like earlier in the game I was settling. You know, and I think that kind of set the tone. I think earlier in the game I just got to look to get to the cup. You know, play inside out, be in that attack mode, and then my jumper will start falling.
I noticed Marcus Howard was super active in your guys' huddles in the second half, especially with you. What's your guys' relationship like, and why do you think he felt like he was increased energy with the people?
Marcus is my brother. You know, just not only is he a very talented basketball player, but he's an even better human being. And he just wants to see us win. He shares our success. And he was just being an inspiration, and we needed that. And yeah, I love that dude, man.
Aaron, you guys have the 23rd ranked defense and the 6th ranked defense over there. Is that just a random thing that's happening right now, or is there something that's going on at home that's a little bit different?
That's quite the discrepancy. I'm not sure. I'm not sure. Maybe we are too lax when we come home. You know, we feel comfortable. We feel complacent. Yeah, I mean, we just got to turn it up. I would say that was lackadaisical. When we come home, we feel comfortable.
Aaron, you say you guys are too quiet on defense. How does that get addressed, especially with no practice time? You say something, does Joker say something?
Oh, that's on me. That's on me. You know, I got to be the staple of this defense. You know, I got to be kind of like the captain of the defense. You know, and I got to just talk. I got to make sure that I'm explaining where I'm at, what I'm doing, what needs to happen, and then just having a constant line of communication with 4 other players on the floor. And I take that upon myself. I was too quiet tonight on defense.
Aaron, you, Monte, and Nikola check in with 9+ minutes left. 7-point game. It seems like, you know, momentum's on your side and the building's ready to pop. They score the next 9 points, make it 16. What stands out about that stretch?
I think our lack of organization, offensively and defensively. You know, I thought we were just a little scrambled. We didn't quite know exactly what we were trying to get into offensively, and then on defensively, we were just late. We weren't in our spots.
Aaron, do you think something like defense with you guys, you flip the switch in the playoffs, and all of a sudden, when the games really, really matter, it just flipped into gear, or do you need to build those habits specifically over these next two games?
No, I mean, you want to build habits, but like I said, we're the team that we are. You know, we're not looking to our future selves. You know, we're here, we are who we are now, and we have the capability to do it. And that's what it comes down to, just doing it.
Aaron, how aware were you tonight of what was going on with Minnesota?
A little bit. I heard they were losing, but honestly, it doesn't really matter. You know, the only thing that matters is what's happening in our locker room and what's happening on the floor out there within our team. So that's the only thing that we care about. We just care about what's happening with us. The rest will take care of itself.
You are who you are, you can, as a team. What conversations are you having with Jamal about him potentially coming back and considering
that? Tell him to take his time. You know, you don't want to rush this. This isn't something to rush off of injury, especially coming back in such a high-level game as a playoffs. Obviously, we need him. You know, we can use him, obviously. But numero uno is him, you know, and in his health and well-being. That's the number one thing. It doesn't, nothing else matters past that. Once he feels that he's healthy completely, sure, come back to the team and help us and be Jamal Murray, you know, and be the Blue Arrow. But first things first, take care of yourself.
Is he receptive to that when you
I hope so. He's a dog, so he want to be out there on the floor with us. That's why we love him. That's why I respect him so much. He's like, feel like a caged lion or a caged animal, waiting to be let out.
But,
you just gotta relax, man. Timing is everything.
Is it up to Jamal?
I suppose it is. Why not? I feel like if he says he's good, he's good. If he's not, he's not.
All right. Appreciate it.